Going on, YouTubers. Moparman 1978 here, just giving you a quick update. Been having a crazy work schedule for the past month and a half. Working everything from 8 in the morning to 4 in the afternoon to 12 to close to 2 to close, back and forth continuously. Not really gonna be able to get anything done on my projects. And looks like since we're in the month of December now, it looks like it's starting to mellow out on the work schedule. I'm starting to get, I think, back to my regular hours. Unfortunately, I think there's like 4 or 5 days in a row I got to work anywhere from 8 in the morning to like, or yeah, till 4 in the afternoon, or 10 to 5 or 11 to 7 or whatever. But anyway, and then I've got like 2 days off in a row or 3 days off in a row. I think what it is besides the holidays, we had a guy that works in our department, that was out for surgery, and I don't know if he's still recuperating or if he hasn't even gone in yet, and we're just waiting for the approval for him to come back so maybe the schedule can get back to normal and I can get back to my regular hours. But anyway, and then all this past week, 7 days total, I was out sick with the flu. There was the main days, of course, when you just feel like junk and you don't want to really do nothing. You got to take medications and then go take some NyQuil and some other stuff and knock yourself out so you can get some rest. But anyway, this is pretty, felt like a pretty stout flu. I haven't had flu and any major colds in quite a while. I've had the corona bug quite a while back, but that was pretty intense. I missed almost 2 weeks of that, of work. But anyway, this one was almost a lot of hacking stuff up. I think most of it was sinus drainage, and then having to cough that stuff up all the time. And anyway, luckily I didn't have to deal with the normal stuff that comes along with the flu, the spewing at the other end. But anyway, some people have dealt a little bit with the stuff from the other end, but not from here. But anyway, the rest of the family has been sick at home as well. But we're all recuperating, and I got it to where I'm just now been able to, I still got some drainage from my regular sinuses, my allergies on top of my flu, so I'm dealing with all that junk. But anyway, I wanted to update you because of the work, the batshit crazy work schedule, and then the flu on top of that. That's really put a dampener into me working on the project, especially the Valiant, the Dodge pickup. I want to get the Dodge pickup going again. Unfortunately, I'm gonna have to wait another week or two to get some regular paychecks because this flu cut into about almost a week and a half of being out sick. Luckily, I only missed 2, maybe 3 days of regular work. The rest of the days were I was off like 3 days in a row. Starting this month of December, I've got like 2 days in a row off or 3 days in a row off. It's just weird. It's these weird schedules. Anyway, so maybe I can, but if it's not snowing and icing and just absolutely nasty out. Hold on. Excuse me. Anyway, I can get back to working on this stuff, and maybe by January I can get a regular schedule going again, and maybe our co-worker will be back, that sort of thing. But anyway, this is just an update to let you know. Haven't been feeling well to do any videos, be outside, let alone be outside in the elements, plus being sick. That's not a good combination. You don't want to catch pneumonia, stuff like that. That's pretty much the only thing is I've been ordering little parts here and there out of each check instead of trying to pay for them all at once. So I still have some money to run on throughout the week. But I got off of eBay the pack of the little plastic push-in twist little inserts for the back of the instrument cluster that you put the instrument cluster light bulbs in. I got those a pretty reasonable deal. I don't remember if I mentioned that in the last video that I did or not. I think I paid like 20-some bucks plus shipping for like a pack of like 12 or 15 of those off of eBay. I still got to order the decal set to go on the instrument gauges from year one. They only have them listed as a 65 Barracuda, to fit a 65 Barracuda, but the 65 Valiant ones use the same instrument gauges. So keep that in mind if you got a Valiant and you need a new set of decals to go over your old instruments. And then I'm still working on the steering wheel. I got more of that completed before I got sick. I got to finish doing the major cracks that go all the way down to the framework on the steering wheel. I got majority of those filled in with that special two-part white epoxy Marine Tex. I just got to finish up the actual handle, and then I can get it somehow figure out how I'm going to get maybe I can turn the makeshift carport back there, put some plastic down on the sides and put a heater in there and make that a makeshift paint booth to put the steering wheel in primer and then in paint and then put a clear coat on the steering wheel, get that crap all done. But anyway, I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and finish getting the brakes done. I got to get the that front seal on the rear end replaced. Once I get that done, I'll get the tires and rims and everything put back on, get the brakes working, get the interior cleaned up, go from there, and I'm going to try to see if I can't drive this up and down the block before I park it in another position to get, so I, what I want to do is I want to, or I might just leave it here, yank out the transmission and the drive shaft, the trunnion drive shaft, because I've got a 70s transmission with 70s drive shaft to put in this, like I've mentioned in the past video, to upgrade it, and maybe at a later date and time I will take that transmission, the upgraded transmission, out and do like Shane suggested from Slant Daily Garage, and I think get like, was it a 518 automatic transmission from out of like a 90s Dakota with a V8 or something in it, and it has the lockup torque converter, and he says the lockup torque converters work so much better with these cars with the slant 6. Just watch his channel if you haven't seen his channel yet. Shane from Slant Daily Garage. He's got some pretty cool cars, and he's got a lot of knowledge and expertise on troubleshooting and technical stuff dealing with transmissions, and especially slant 6s. His expertise on the slant 6 stuff goes a little bit more than I do. Some of the stuff I didn't know, I've learned from him already just watching his videos. So check him out. Anyway, until next time, until the next video.